Yeah.
Well, anyway, I want to run over there.
Do I not get to solder his mouth together?
You can do that.
Yes. That's all I wanted. Okay. Unleashing powers. I do not have good freak. That is a 6. You know what? I'm going to use one of my rerolls because I have 2 of them and I need to use them.
Don't forget, you can buy rerolls through the donation tab or through Revlo.
And that is still a 6. You know what?
Wait.
I'm going to.
I can, if I help you.
That could be a 7.
Yeah.
That could be a 7. And I would have to spend a team?
Yes.
All right.
You'd have to tell me how you do it.
Well,
if
I help you through destructive, criminal, or rule breaking actions, I can get a +2 instead of a +1 when I spend a team from the pool.
Can they see us? Or is it like.
It's kind of like.
That's only on your roll.
Like,
though, right?
Yeah.
No. That's
not
if I help.
So it's like a bowl.
It's a bowl. Right. You're in a bowl.
Got it. As long as it's through destructive, criminal, or rule-breaking actions.
I would say soldering somebody's mouth together is pretty rule-breaking.
But how would I help you in a rule-breaking way? All right, where are you in all of this?
I'm standing with y'all.
I keep imagining the three of you just kind of like standing next to each other inside the anvil hole.
Here's the thing. You just place a comforting hand on my shoulder blade and it is enough.
So wait.
That's not rule breaking.
You're
encouraging it though. Because it's not.
You're not entirely sure what's with the dome and they haven't done anything yet, so not yet.
Okay.
I got a plan. It's going to be cool.
I can just take it as potential. It's fine. Ain't no big thing.
All right. Well, I guess we could save a team.
If you want.
If I see them around.
It ain't no thing.
Then I want to like yell up and be like, let me handle this one, everyone. I need this.
Oh.
That would be acting selfishly, but we'll do that on your turn.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay. So you're not gonna spend the team.
No.
Okay,
no.
So
I'll save it
take
for
potential.
Whom?
Me.
Okay.
Yeah.
I already marked it.
So you try to solder his mouth.
Oh wait. Shut. I'm sorry. I just apparently last time I filled out all my potentials and I can take.
Oh yeah, we talked about that, but then you had to go to a wedding.
Let's pause.
Oh, yeah.
Go to the inventory screen real quick.
This was a long time ago.
I played Resident Evil 7 this week.
Yeah, you beat it too, right?
Oh my god, it's like my favorite game of all time now.
Apparently,
but yeah,
I
the inventory screen haunts my nightmares.
Oh boy, I played the demo. I quite enjoyed the demo.
Go tell it, Rhodey.
I had my first class for my Intro to Judaism class.
Mazel tov. So,
mazel tov.
Yeah, yeah. For chat, I'm in the process of converting to Judaism, so I'm gonna join Steven in the tribe.
Yeah, I know.
And I'm already like halfway there because my therapist.
You're ready to hate the month of December.
Hey, my therapist. I was talking to him about it, and he's like, "Yeah, you've already got like." Being, you know, you got the mentality down. You're guilty about everything. You know, you just kind of like, yeah. So.
Oh, wait, I think I did it already, actually.
Did you?
To rearrange my labels.
Oh, that's what
you
chose to
been.
Do.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Okay, so. Mm-hmm. Anyway, Jack. Mm-hmm. So Buckshot tries to solder Anvil's mouth shut.
Mm hmm.
But you're a little distracted, like, you're not sure, you don't want to get him hurt, and he's right in the middle of it, mm-hmm. and it's taking a lot of focus.
And I'm so excited Dirt is there, too.
And Dirt's there, but he is just so mad.
I know, he's so cool, though.
He is so mad.
I love him so much. He's, like, the greatest person.
You pretty much just end up making a bunch of sparks fly out of Anvil's mouth.
Oh, yikes.
Anvil has a moment of, what the fuck, but I'm actually enjoying this because this probably looks really cool.
Oh, yikes.
Even though Atlas Shrugged removed your -1 from being blind, you get a -1 now because there are sparks flying in your face.
Sure.
All right. You two, what are you doing?
But don't I get a +1 for Atlas Shrugged on one move?
I believe you get +1 on your next Unleash Powers.
For one Unleash Powers, right?
Yes.
Cool.
Chaos Light.
+2.
+2 on your next Unleash Powers.
Dope!
Dope.
You gotta find a way to unleash some powers.
Because I'm concerned about that guy, this guy.
That guy.
I want to provoke...
This Wall of Meat, who is now just kind of like a really athletic-looking buff guy in a skin-tight onesie.
Yeah. Well, no, I don't want to provoke Swole.
No.
I want to provoke the guy that he's fighting. Just because, yeah, like, Anvil. You can't do this alone, bud.
I want to.
And I say no.
Well, you don't know how you say it yet.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm going to try to provoke that guy. And yell, like, hey, stupid big tall guy with muscles.
Whoa.
And teeth.
Them some fighting words.
What do you think you're doing picking on a little guy? Oh, I'm provoking both of them. Anyway.
Oh, no. Because of that, you will be provoking both of them.
Classic chaos a lot.
Wah-nah-nah-nah-nah-nah. Word choice.
Yeah! 11. Damn.
Success.
Plus superior. Ooh, I got plus 2 superior.
What are you trying to get us to do?
I don't know.
We always forget that about provoke. You're
supposed
to declare
to have like a goal in mind to provoke.
What is your provocation?
Well, my goal is to get them to stop fighting each other. That's really my goal, just because I'm trying to get a handle on the situation, and you guys are just being ridiculous. We're about to get banned from this club that I like.
But what are you doing exactly?
Oh, I'm yelling.
Apart from calling him a big, fat, ugly poo face.
I'm yelling those things, and I'm running toward them, trying to get between them. Do I need more than that?
I'll let you do it.
Okay.
Do you have, like, a psychic move that you could...
Yeah, I could also psychically force push them away from each other.
Psychic Moves, the new album by the Sacred Kings.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm not gonna do it, so... That will mark a condition for me, but I'll take it.
But it's plus 10.
Yeah, no.
Which means that I can still choose to not do it and then take a condition.
So, just to be clear, your provocation is stop fighting Swole.
Yeah.
All right.
So
you jump out of the hole, land pretty cool. You know, it's not your first, you know, jumping out of the second story window sort of situation. And then gracefully, and you just put the psychic bubble between the two of them.
Yeah, okay, imagine a flip, and then I land, like, on one knee with...
Superhero pose, it's really bad for the knee.
Well, no, I did a flip, and then landed on my knee.
Still bad for the knee.
Okay. He's gonna get up and go, ah, fuck. He specifically actually wears knee pads under his pants, just for instances like this.
Yeah, Castellan strikes me as a knee pad on the outside kind of guy.
Yeah.
And...
Just on the one knee, though.
Yeah. And you put up your psychic bubble between the two of them, pushing you into the dirt wall and Anvil into the other side of the dirt wall.
Yeah.
Of this dirt bowl, thunderbowl, as I'm going to keep calling it.
Thunderbowl?
Thunderbowl.
Nice. The thunderbowl.
Thunderbowl run. So you drop the bubble, basically, call him. Oh. You fucking bitch. You couldn't even, like, do it yourself. You gotta get your friends involved.
Hey.
Fine. Whoa. Roll takes powerful blow.
One, it's takes supposed a swing to be rise. They rise to the bait and do what I want. So my want was to get them to go away.
You wanted him to stop fighting
Swole. Stop fighting me.
All right, sure.
You want him to stop fighting Swole. He's not fighting Swole. He's
semantics.
Fighting
Yeah,
it's, take a powerful
it's
blow.
It's not like a mind control provoke.
No. You guys don't have that superpower.
Yet.
There's something for the new books to come out for this.
Ha ha! Wait, what do I add?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
No, yeah, you like, did not and, succeed,
Cable
Nicole.
And oh. Other books.
Okay.
Super excited about it.
Well, I failed badly.
By succeeding.
You rolled really well at a time you really didn't want to.
Yeah.
Can I defend, actually? If he's coming at Canzalot?
No. I kind of already had your move, so.
Oh, okay.
I haven't gone yet.
My bad's gone yet.
Oh, I didn't know that was like a separate.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Nicole, you roll 10 plus. Tell the audience what happens.
Okay, so I'm guessing he comes to punch me.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so I lose my powers in a terrible way.
Oh, that's what you choose to do?
Yeah. Well, it's not permanent, right?
No.
Okay. So once he punches me, I lose control of my powers. I have the power projection, and suddenly everybody that is there, that is present, looks like somebody else. That's a bad thing. So maybe...
they all look like John Malkovich.
Maybe some innocent people kind of look like Buckshot and look like Swole. People keep changing, and like...
Also, my force powers kind of just like go nuts. So people are getting pushed down and knocked over.
So you're having a carry at the end of the prom scene moment.
Not on purpose. It's out of my control, baby.
Yes, it is. Because you took one hell of a punch.
Yeah. So, and I
basically, this entire arm feels like a bruise.
I am a problem right now.
You are a problem. And everyone's kind of shifting faces and everything.
Shifting faces and, like, physical bodies. Like, they're just getting pushed over, like, a ton. It's like there's a big wind getting thrown around.
Yeah. So, Kid Stardust, who currently looks like Buckshot and currently kind of trying to dodge people being flung at you. What are
you
doing?
Well, I actually have not descended to the level as of everybody else.
No.
Still on the edge of the wall that is being blown out. She kind of tilts her head and
I don't think I ever left the edge of the wall.
Gets this quizzical look on her face like,
I'm still up there with you.
And then her eyes start to crackle pink and black, and she kind of raises her hands. And God damn it.
Just what was that?
I was going to charge up my burn, but on a miss, I hold two burn and mark three conditions.
Jesus.
Do you take potential?
No.
Okay.
Wow.
So I am
really bad at this.
Guys. It's really hard to focus on charging up because everything's
okay. I'm afraid. I'm angry.
Okay.
And I'm insecure because this is a new thing. So I have two burn. So basically, what you guys see is from the ground up, there starts to form this basically anvil-sized Gundam robot made out of pink and black energy. And she looks over at Buckshot and she's like, I didn't really feel like getting punched in the face. I'm going to try this.
Okay.
So yeah, it kind of just comes into life and starts edging
Buckshot
towards
Buckshot kind of looks like Kevin, just shorter.
Yeah.
Just peanut sized.
Yeah. No, okay. Like I'm making other people look like other people, but also their forms and like their proportions are off.
So yeah, now there's a pink and black energy robot on the field of battle.
Cool. So I do want, so now that like everyone's done their stuff,
right.
I want to yell like, guys, I can do this, okay? Let me have this, let me have a little bit of one-on-one or he's always going to say I couldn't do it.
Look, I'm not disparaging your abilities. I just don't want you to get punched into the ground, okay?
I can handle it! And then I want to like kick off the wall behind me and like try and like bullet myself at
you are at a +2 for a freak move, but this sounds more like engaging your threat. However,
probably.
I'm gonna go ahead and say you're acting selfishly.
Sure.
You lose team for the pool, but you get to add you shift your labels and add 2 to your roll.
Nice. I'm going to
shift down mon.
I think I'll shift up danger and shift down mundane for this because that makes sense, right?
It really does.
This is me, like, wanting to just fucking rip through things and not just be a normal person anymore. So, yeah, I just, like, try and rocket myself at him, enjoying the, like, increased mobility that I have for the whole thing.
You're not, like, super speed, but you're just, like,
an
athletic fast guy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I just am real strong and I'm pushing myself off something. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, because I just upped my danger a little bit.
Nice.
So, yeah. That's engaging a threat, right?
Yes.
So, I'm going to choose to avoid or resist their blows and surprise them.
All right. You catch him completely off guard because he's kind of standing over Kevin, thinking, all right, fine, fuck it. 2 against 1, not fair, I'll make it fair. You just come out of nowhere, hit him in the side of the face. You hear his teeth kind of crack.
Mm-hmm. Distasteful.
And he hits the dirt wall really hard.
As he hits it, I land on him, I'm gonna be like, eyes on the prize, big boy, let's do this!
However, as he crashes into the wall, he also knocks down Kid Stardust's robot.
No! The Stardust Gundam!
That's
all right. I kind of want to name it, but I can't think of anything outside of Star Eva.
about that, chat.
Chat, do you have a name for Stardust Imaginary Gundam?
Keep in mind, David Bowie themed. Wink. I winked and then said wink.
I know.
I'm
called Major Tom.
fire.
Ooh, ooh, I like that.
Is there a Diet Coke in there?
There is a Diet Coke in there. Would you like it?
Yes, please.
Dom Zook, do you need anything?
I'm okay.
All right.
Can I just get a regular Coke?
Yes, you can, Jack Kelly. Yes, you can.
Thank you.
There's caffeine in this, right?
You good?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm good. I still got my Guinness. There's caffeine in Diet Coke, I promise.
Cool. All
right. So, what I'm calling Major Tom until the chat decides on a better name.
Sure.
Is knocked down.
Okay. It doesn't dissipate, though.
No, it's still standing.
Yeah.
What do you three do?
Homo sapiens. No. That didn't work.
What?
Homo superiors.
No. I see where you're going, but...
Yeah, I hear it. No. Yeah.
Sailors fighting in a dance hall. Okay, anyway.
We'll come back to it. We'll come back to it.
I finally
you never did answer if there's life on Mars.
I finally am able to gain composure and control of myself.
Everything feels like a bruise.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm in pain. But I see what's happening with Swole. I see that the last time I got involved, it was a bad idea. So I don't know what to do. Let's see. I guess I'm just going to try to support him or comfort him. Comfort him, because he's angry. I want to make him a little less angry, a little more control over his emotions.
All right.
So, well, I'm not actually the condition angry.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I probably should be.
I mean, if you feel like you should have the condition, I'd go ahead and take it.
Sure.
If you're angry and you know what Mark
I'd say doing. I'd say I'm angry from being hit in the face over and over again.
Yeah, I would earlier. Too. Shit.
But then everyone decided to get up in your business.
Yeah, fucking business. People. This is personal, guys.
Can you just, like, take it as a sign that we care about you?
I'm just saying. You gotta give me my fight. This guy, like, he's already said, like, oh, you had to have your friends come help you. I'm like, damn it.
All right, rolling. 7 plus...
Plus mundane.
Plus 1. 8.
All right.
Cool, so...
So go ahead and read comfort and support.
When you comfort or support someone, roll plus mundane. On a hit, they hear you. They mark potential, clear condition, or shift labels if they open up to you. Swole, I think you've got him. Just calm down. Let's figure out what the next move is going to be.
Does he still seem, like, conscious and, like, fighting and stuff?
Oh, he's very much awake.
Yeah.
I mean, you have pushed him through 2 walls now. Well, a wall and a half.
Mm-hmm.
But he's very much conscious.
Okay, then I'm gonna like crack my neck and go, not yet! Sorry.
But I succeeded.
But I still have to open up to you. What happens if I don't open up to you?
Doesn't say.
Okay, even if you don't open up to him, go ahead.
Can I open up and, like, it doesn't have to stop me from fighting.
Yeah, no, it doesn't have to stop the fight. It just has to, like, give you guys a moment.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna be like, he's still on his feet. Look, I need this, okay? I'll be okay.
Well, I mean, I think my goal here was to find a different way to end this situation.
Yeah, it was your goal, but you were trying, but you comforted and supported, so.
Yeah.
Mark potential or clear condition?
All right, I'm going to, I'm not gonna clear angry. I'll mark condition. Potential.
Okay. Alright. What about you two? What are you doing?
Fucking hell. Major Tom's gonna kind of mecha up from the dirt and these things open up on the shoulders and this barrage of rockets just comes launching out an anvil.
I'm gonna need you to spend another vote for this.
What was that?
I'm gonna need you to spend another burn.
Okay. Well,
keeping the robot alive and having it fire stuff, like, is this one of your moves?
Okay, here's how constructs works. Spend one burn to create any object with your powers up to the size of a person, which I did.
Right.
Spend an additional burn to animate it independently of yourself. Okay. This construct dissolves at the end of the scene, which I had intended to say I was doing at last turn, but I neglected to do so.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry for that.
Appreciate it. So don't spend the second burn,
okay.
But go ahead.
No, I did. I mean, but that's already done.
Right.
So anyway. Nope.
Wow.
Whole lot of nothing. Because I'm at a -2 as well. So that's 2.
Oh, shit.
But you definitely mark potential on that, right? Like, it's still a failed roll.
Mark potential.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because I was going to assist you if it was close to something else, but...
It's okay. And she kind of looks at you and is like, I don't know what I'm doing.
So your barrage misses the targets entirely. Mm-hmm. Instead, more or less destroys the dirt wall.
Okay.
And dirt down on the ground floor. God damn it!
Dirt, we got this. You can go inside.
Tell me, how are you doing here? It's a school night.
We're busy.
Yeah, you should be busy with school. What the hell are you doing here? I'm telling your mama.
She knows, okay?
Oh, she does not. Don't lie to me.
I'm jumping down from the second floor. I'm actually going to pick up one of the things that you, like the rockets.
Oh,
that
they're just made out of like energy.
Yeah, no, they're not actual rockets.
Okay.
It's like Green Lantern constructs. They're not.
Oh, we have some names for your robot.
Oh, great.
Gun Dust.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Wildcat O-Matic.
Ooh. Okay.
The Goblin King.
Ah.
I like it, but maybe for something else.
Mm-hmm.
Starman.
Starman.
That's
good.
That's pretty great.
Glitter Crotch. And finally, Ziggy.
Oh, Ziggy.
Yeah, you got it's some Ziggy. Ziggies.
It's totally
Could
Ziggy.
Could be Ziggy Starman.
Let's just go with Ziggy.
All right. Yeah. So whenever you create your Ziggy. Construct,
Wait,
it is named Ziggy. Dom, do we know who made Ziggy?
Matt, 510M.
On a fucking roll,
dude. Matt, 510. Dude, you're the best.
Matt's killing it.
You are invested in this story, and I appreciate that.
Yeah, thank you.
I do, too. So as you jump down, Dirt stops yelling at you, and you're not sure why. And you glance over, and you see you see about five mad scientist-looking motherfuckers.
Oh, mother.
Chips and whey.
Bitch.
Whips and chains. I couldn't remember what I was saying. And Kiganis has purchased, Send in the Mooks.
Yeah.
What is?
Send in the Mooks is when, five bad guys show up.
Cool. Were you here when we fought those cultists?
Yes, you were. That's where you had your big meltdown.
Yeah, I've been having a lot of bad meltdowns.
Kevin's had a rough. So yes, Kiganis has purchased Send in the Mooks, and they've arrived at the fight.
I'm surprised
that... And they look mad.
Okay.
Kiganis, just real quick, Kiganis, I'm not sure if you want to go with the mad scientist theme. It's just kind of what worked earlier. Send me a message through Twitter or Patreon. We can work something out. Okay? Great.
Great. So
I can talk to them on another chat.
They're just eggs to me. The chat. They're Twitter eggs.
Eggs.
I like eggs. They're good over easy.
I just had them.
Mix
this morning.
Them with cheese, yeah. Got protein, good cholesterol, healthy cholesterol.
Les œufs en français.
Omelette du fromage.
They can turn into birds.
Lizards.
Yeah. Anyway.
About parents who understand. Anyway.
So is the robot actually made out of metal or is it just energy?
It's like a pink energy robot.
Damn.
Yeah. It's translucent. I mean, you can see kind of through it.
Damn. You see some scientists and they all look pretty pissed off.
Okay. Well, I'm guessing
you get the feeling they're not actually scientists.
So since we're like on the street,
yes,
I'm supposing there's some trash cans.
Oh yeah.
I'm just gonna, crumple a couple of them and then just fling them at the cultists. Just a super simple, just.
Okay. So go ahead and roll lashing out with the Mooks.
That's not a move that I have. do you
roll combat?
Directly engage a threat?
Directly engage a threat. You know what
I mean. Okay. I'm just saying. I am going to actually do Fight the Good Fight, which is one of my moves. When you pull your punches while directly engaging a threat, you can roll plus savior instead of plus danger. If you do, you cannot choose to impress, surprise, or frighten your foe. So I'm just going to roll for that.
Okay.
I haven't done it in a while. And I do not. That would be a six, actually.
Oh, yeah. If someone wants to throw in team.
No, yes.
Reroll.
Oh, I was going to reroll, but.
Okay. You're going to reroll.
Yeah, you got it. Might as well use it.
Whoop. Yeah, that's a little bit better. So that's a 9.
If we use team, we can make it a 10.
Mm-hmm.
This is true.
So if you. Go ahead.
Sure.
Yeah.
Tell me how you use it, though.
Okay, so you're throwing
Just throwing trash cans at them. Yeah. Just crumpled, like, they're just almost like cannons in a way.
If I use my criminal one, I could throw people.
She does one of those whistle things that, hey, jerks, over here. just distracts them long enough so they're like, huh? And how's that?
The dumbest of the scientist falls for it, okay. Flying sinker, and
yes.
Then your trash can make contact with him.
Okay, so my pick two, I am going to say I am going to resist or avoid their blows, and I'm going to create an opportunity for my allies.
All right.
Because I don't know what I would take from them. Their dignity?
No. All right, I'd like to directly engage a threat, so I will directly engage them.
With Anvil or the Mooks?
Ooh. I mean, I'm tired of engaging Anvil. It's not worked out for me. I will engage the Mooks. So if I wanted to engage more than one of them, is that possible, or would that be unleashing my powers?
I'm going to say that's unleashing your powers.
Okay.
And you're at a negative for that because everything is still kind of screwy.
Yeah. Am I at a negative for engaging a threat?
If you use your powers, yes. It's just for one round. Just for one
round. Yeah. All right. I'm going to indirectly engage a threat with my powers.
Go for it.
Do it.
So, I'm going to hit the floor, and that'll send a psychic wave push to them, and it should make them stumble. And,
Nine.
Wait, great. 9 plus danger. So it's 10.
Nine.
Minus 1.
So it's 9.
So it's 9.
Yay.
You got very excited there for a second.
All right, cool. I can make it take something from them.
What are you going to take?
I don't know. What do they have?
what they got?
Chains, whips, beakers, lab coats.
Okay. I'm going to smash all their beakers. Don't know if they were ever going to be able to use them, but they're broken now.
Oh, but if you take the chains...
I want to break their beakers. Okay. I'm going to break them where it hurts. Science.
Hit them with science.
You shatter glass, so all their beakers burst, and they all have... It's like a thing. And they are surrounded by broken glass.
Yeah, you are.
Next one to attack him gets a plus one.
Yeah, they will.
Yeah. However, one of them throws a trash can lid at you and hits. Market condition.
Wait, why?
Because you didn't roll to dodge. You were rolling to engage the enemy?
Oh, yeah.
You didn't select
resist
their blows.
Or avoid their blows. All right, so I'm marking a condition.
iDragon has purchased... Okay. God, I look cool.
Cool. Well, then I'm going to be using that when I can.
On your next turn, right?
Yeah. I marked afraid, BT dubs.
I'm at a -2 for everything I would like to do, so I want to try and clear at least one of these conditions.
You can mark it through a friend helping you or being an idiot.
Ooh.
Well, what conditions do you have?
Afraid, angry, and insecure.
Yeah.
Do you want some assistance?
Just be an idiot.
Okay.
You're trying to clear those?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. How can you be an idiot and clear them?
Well, you clear insecure by proving you're a big dick baller. You clear afraid by doing something foolhardy and something you think is cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you clear angry by blowing off steam.
Okay.
Hurt someone or break something important.
Or how about if someone hugs you?
That would be comforting. That's comforting. That could always help.
Good to know. What if you hug someone?
Okay, we're looking for something stupid. Since Ziggy doesn't seem to be effective in any way,
she
immediately flies out the window and goes right for Anvil to try and go toe-to-toe with him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
So, Jordan, you and Anvil are in that, like, sort of thing, like,
so that
unstoppable force, immovable object.
Is that clear afraid?
That will clear angry or afraid, your call.
I'm gonna go with afraid.
All right. Because
that'll at least allow me to engage threats.
And you see this, and you're just like,
God damn it! Ah!
Exactly. And boom. You,
I feel like Mark, I just hit
him. Are you angry?
Yes. Yes, I'm angry.
Oh, yeah. Now you're especially angry because, once again, they're not letting you have your fight, and you are flying at about 35 miles per hour down the street with Anvil.
Mm-hmm.
That's fast.
he's leaving a nice anvil skin mark behind him.
You. Mm. Yeah. I know what you mean, so but I'm picturing something else.
I know, we all are. Word choices.
So wait, is Dirt's arena not...
Dirt's arena was destroyed.
Okay. Has he gone inside? What is he doing? I'm just wondering. My own notification, sorry.
Dirt is here, was purchased through one of many, so he is here to help you.
Okay.
Why don't you tell me what Dirt's doing?
Oh, no. I want Michael to finish his turn.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, you did?
Yeah,
okay. He's hanging out nearby. Dirt, go inside. Go to your date. I know you kept messaging me about it earlier. Go,
Hey, I'm a hero. I help.
So I think what he's, God, what would he do? I don't know. Cause they've kind of slid away.
Right.
And what are you doing right now?
Me? Well, I just, the guy I was fighting just got pushed away from me.
Okay.
So I'm gonna give chase. Fucking book it to get after him. Yeah.
I think he sees you running and like almost gives you like a dirt, like a wave push, so it gets you there faster.
In the right direction.
Yeah.
Like a shockwave?
Yeah, kind of.
All right, so.
So I want to basically.
You'll be at a plus one.
Okay, I want to like just run as fast as I can, you know, just like fucking barrel after him.
And Kiss Stardust as well.
Well, it's just your Gundam thing, right? It's
no, this is me actually having engaged him.
Oh, okay.
Since the Gundam thing wasn't really.
The Gundam thing didn't work.
Yeah. First time, you know?
It was an experiment.
Yeah.
We'll work out the bugs.
Yeah.
That was an alpha. Okay, so just for my clarification, dealing with mad scientist.
Yep.
Engaged with Anvil.
Flying away with, well, not flying away, but like skidding away with Anvil. Chasing after Anvil.
Mad scientist.
And you're dealing with Matt. Okay, so
I'm
Dust
mad
is
scientist.
Helping him out.
Dirt is how.
All right, so
helping,
one of the... So what do you do? Because we already talked, Dirt's helping him, but what do you do?
What do I do?
Yeah.
Charlie, I'm still dealing with the mad scientists.
Okay, so how? Are you fighting them? Are you talk to them?
No, there's no talking to these people.
You can't talk to scientists.
No.
You don't negotiate with scientists.
No.
Those motherfuckers lying.
Topical. Yeah.
Too real.
Yeah.
Too real.
You shouldn't.
Those motherfuckers are lying and getting me pissed. Yeah.
You know the Juggalos are going to have a march?
I know.
I'm so excited.
Wait, for or against?
I don't know.
Okay. I think
it's
for Juggalos.
Yeah. That's all Juggalos. Everything about Juggalos is pro-Juggalo.
Yeah.
All I know is I'm stuck in a Perspal Age, and all I'm thinking is, oh, this is how the aliens not only win, but we end up with the first Juggalo president.
No, are you kidding? The aliens are going to be flying here, see what's happening, and be like, fuck no. I'm getting out of here.
No, they've been waiting for Trump's America to make contact.
Y'all ever seen that movie, Star Trek, First Contact? That's what it's going to be like. Borg Queen and all.
They're not ready.
Hillbilly's talking about Swamp Rat. Hillbilly's talking about Borg Queen's my new favorite thing. New favorite thing.
So since they're carrying like chains and stuff, and you
and one of them has a Bunsen burner flamethrower, as Kiganis has just informed me.
Mm. But also,
that's a good wrinkle.
There's no Bunsens for them to burn because I broke all of them.
How should a flamethrower?
Bunsen burner flamethrower.
I thought Bunsen
is this nonsense.
I think it's the best. If
what
you're
the
at.
Fuck is this nonsense?
But more important, they got no beakers.
No beakers.
So those
I'm
Bunsens
sorry.
Will be burning.
I'm
nothing.
Just like, y'all not aware of how big a Bunsen burner is? Because it's pretty fucking small. Like, how the fuck are you making a Bunsen burner flamethrower?
Mad science, Jack. Mad science.
No, I like that it is so tiny, but it's all like.
This is why you shouldn't trust science. This is also why I got C's and D's in science.
I got an A.
A's and B's and everything else. Just not good at science.
I was
a shit high school student. Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And you still are.
Thank you. I am shit, aren't I?
Yeah, they want to know why.
No, you're a shit high school student. Mostly because you're 26.
Yeah, you're true. You're a high school student.
I'm enrolled.
Okay, so. So they're like, fuck, I want to get rid of that fucking flamethrower. But I think I'm going to use the chains that they're holding and just like try and wrap one of them around.
Okay.
You know.
Roll engage the threat.
Someone who is doing the thing. Nope. Nope.
That's been a reroll on you.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Or you could just let me have the potential.
Do you want the potential?
Yeah, because it fills up my track.
Okay, take the potential then.
I will take that potential. Okay.
Now roll take a powerful blow as the Bunsen flamethrower, which really got under your skin for some reason.
Okay.
That amuses me.
Oh, no, they're not. I wouldn't say they're more powerful than me.
Definitely not.
Okay.
They're mooks.
So I can't take my never give up, never surrender.
No.
And I succeed because I rolled a 4.
Oh.
You succeeded by failing.
Mm-hmm. Well, mark a new potential.
Hey.
And and just tell me, do you know what you're going to advance to or?
I have no fucking clue because I wasn't expecting to fill up my potential track.
Oh, okay then. That
So, but I do have to say how I weather the blow.
Yes, please do.
What did they do to me? Bunsen burner, flamethrower. I think it's just because I'm so used to, you know, it's like metal can be heated, but not destroyed. So it's just literally just like hunkering down and just kind of like almost like charging up and like using my elemental powers to kind of like protect myself in a way, just like from like just with it withstanding the heat.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. And metal, fire, makes it more malleable.
See, I see you actually getting like a little like red orange kind
of
as you're
standing. Oh yeah, so if I were to hit somebody right now, it would fucking hurt.
Yeah. Because
it would be hot metal.
Okay, how about this? If you
this isn't a thing that hasn't happened to him before.
Next time you just punch a guy.
Oh shit, can I choose this?
Next time you just punch a guy at a plus.
Fuck. No, no, no. No.
Okay.
No.
All right.
No. No plus one.
So I had a plan before, but no, this is gonna be it. I think I'm gonna actually choose my moment of truth.
Oh. Oh shit!
This is the first time we've had this.
Okay,
Steven,
so,
you want to walk us through it?
Yes. Okay. So, moment of truth is one of my favorite aspects about this game. So, like all apocalypse-powered games, Mask is a really story-driven sort of like players build it just as much as I do, and I guess you guys build it as well. Moment of truth, I give up all control for a brief moment. Jack will have a script that he has to follow, but he can go wherever he wants with it. And he will be the storyteller when he chooses to activate.
Where's the script I have to follow?
It should be on your sheet under Moment of Truth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Read
upper
that
left that on that first thing.
Dramatically.
Go ahead and read it.
Oh, God. I put a piece of tape over part of it because I was really...
Because I run a great game.
No, I have ADHD, and I'm waiting for my fidget cube to get here. It's going to be here on Tuesday.
Nice.
Because I am very fidgety. Okay.
I want to get one of those rings that, you can
Okay. This is the moment when you prove how much the mantle belongs to you. You seize control of all your powers, and you defeat even impossible odds to prove you are worthy of the name you carry. You accomplish feats even your predecessors couldn't do. Of course, after you prove something like that, you can still expect more responsibilities to be placed on your shoulders. So this all it falls into what I was planning on before, but this is better.
That is fantastic.
This is pretty good, too.
So, really, whenever you want, you can say, I'm using my moment of truth.
Can I use it right now?
Let's let everyone else go real quick, because it's going to be kind of a moment.
Okay. Because I know exactly what it is. So.
All right, so Jordan.
Okay, so I imagine I can run pretty fast if I'm, like, really, like, putting everything into it, especially now that I'm not huge, bulky, waddling,
swole. Oh, yeah, no, you're an athletic guy.
Yeah.
And you feel like you're kind of being pushed as well.
Yeah, because I've got, like...
Basically, he was in track and field.
He was.
Yeah.
Well, but shot put. But
okay, as I run, I want to yell, Stardust, get out of my way.
What?
I've already made it clear that I need this fight, and you guys keep intervening.
I know.
So I think Swole's is just gonna basically like blow through this stuff. So yeah, I'm just gonna charge up and I'm gonna yell, get out of the way, but basically what I'm gonna try and do is just like push Stardust to the side if she doesn't get out of the way in time.
Do you?
And then just like deck Anvil.
Yeah. Yeah, she does.
Okay.
But it's super close.
It's too close for anyone's comfort.
Yeah.
All right, you're rolling to deck Anvil. Just
yeah. Just keep engaging a threat, you know?
Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's all you gotta do.
Eight. 8, 9, 10.
You're on fire.
9, 10, 11 for my danger. I forgot I plus 1'd it. So I'm going to hit that. And the two I'm going to choose, I'm not going to choose to resist or avoid their blows because I want to. But what I want to do is I want to take something from them and I want to knock out a few of their metal teeth.
Oh.
That's what I want to do.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. And I'm just going to knock it out and be like, and how's that, condition. Braces?
Oh.
I you called like me it. Four eyes earlier, so. Oh,
wow. Well, way to make people with braces feel bad. Yeah. They're just trying to better themselves.
He's just, you
I
know,
had braces all throughout high school.
Got to play on his too. Thing.
I had braces in elementary school.
I did too. I had really bad teeth and I had to wear them for almost 10 years.
I had an extra adult tooth that had to be pulled down by a gold chain.
I did
chain.
Too.
Jesus. No, I had to
get
too.
I had to get five
Shut
teeth
up.
Removed.
I just had the one and it was right here.
Yeah, and so. Then my wisdom teeth.
So wait, I want to add more details to exactly
please do,
how this
happens. Please, just go ahead.
So basically, you get out of the way, and I just, bam, and I just slam it into his metal mouth, and it like breaks a few of the teeth out. It just like mangles my hand in the process, but I just like hold it up, and it just like, and you like see the bones like reform into the thing.
Ugh.
And so I'm going to choose to take something from him, which is some of his teeth. And
do they just come back on your fist? Like, are the teeth like?
I imagine like
your
one
knuckle.
Of, I'll say like one of them is like.
Steven does not like this visual.
And that doesn't heal. Like it keeps bleeding, and like the broken skin is still there. But like the bones like restructure themselves, like with the like regular muscle around them and stuff. And then I yell what I was saying, like take that braces, and I'm choosing, as I said, to take something from him and. Impress the opposition.
Okay.
But he probably get to hit me.
You
back,
also so. Marked out all his conditions.
Nice.
He is definitely hopeless and very angry and very insecure right now because you bested him.
Yeah.
So, however, he's out cold.
I'm like, damn it! I thought that was a good line!
Well, because Stardust was a good life. You're there.
You okay? Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
Meanwhile.
You couldn't have just let me have that fight on my own.
Look, we're a team.
Yeah, and he beat the shit out of me in front of everyone in that club, okay?
Hey, guys, we kind of need help over here.
We'll talk about this later, okay?
You look over, agreed. You see a bunch of nerds. One of them has a flamethrower.
One of them's beating me over the head with a trash can lid.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is embarrassing.
So, however, you still have I look fucking cool.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna say that even though I'm like sort of mad at you, I'd like to clear angry.
I'll let you clear angry
because I feel like knocking him out.
Oh
was, like,
yeah,
what
no,
I needed
you
for that.
Took you have some of his teeth.
Yes,
you can pocket them if you want.
I'm going to keep one.
This is mine.
God, it sounds so much like one of my D&D characters.
I remember that one.
It sounds like a Coney. Is it mine?
I know what I want to do to unleash my powers.
But yeah.
And also to look fucking cool.
Okay.
All right. As I'm getting...
There's a tense moment when we nod and...
Yeah, we see
there's
still
a
shit
beat
going
panel.
On.
Yeah.
We talk about this later.
Okay.
As I'm getting beat over the head.
Bonk, 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 bonk.
I love that, though. I like, imagine every time it comes back up, I have like a different face and shape and stuff. Like, bruh. okay, so what I want to do is one, to make that stop happening, but two, to unleash my powers. They're wearing chains, right?
Some of them, yeah.
I want to manipulate the chains using my psychic powers to constrain them so they can't fight anymore.
That's what I was trying to do. It failed.
Maybe you can help me.
I'd say I'm gonna be honest, Jack. I'd say your moment of truth for something cooler than a couple mooks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah, do something awesome with it.
I was gonna do something awesome with it. But...
And what does I look fucking cool do?
Let me double check. I look fucking cool.
Yeah.
It's technically called God I look cool, but I've always called it I look fucking cool.
For some reason that makes me think of the that sexy and I know it song.
Kay also does something really cool and leaves her own mind during a fight. You get to add +2 to your next illusion.
Okay, cool.
And it looks really cool.
Yeah. All right. So, and I'm going to make my eyes, like, turn white. Because that'll look cool.
Dope.
And I'm glowing. There's dirt, like, kind of rising around me. And wah-wah, and then the chains go whip, whip, whip. And then they just, like, get all of them kind of, like, stuck together, tied up in a chain thing. So that they can't fight anymore. Is that a thing I can do?
I will let you do that.
Is that a thing I can do?
All right, please don't roll badly. Wait, what am I rolling? Plus freak. Okay. All right, come on. Seven, 8, 9, 10, 11.
You get add 2 because it's illusion.
Cool. Wait. 7, 8, 9.
Excuse
10,
me.
10, 11. I got an 11.
What'd you eat for lunch? All right, you got an 11. So, yeah, they're all chained up. The one with the Buzzbird flamethrower drops it.
Yeah.
All 5 are, like, trying to get out of there, but they can't.
Sweet.
Because I want to see the other playbooks.
Sure. And also, they're not all chained together, like, all standing up, kind of huddled next to each other. It's like they're all, like, in different positions, just uncomfortably. Someone's head is in someone's crotch. It's not fun.
You made a ball. You made a science ball.
Yeah. One saying, Esteban, did you take a shower today? There's a scientist named Esteban.
Also a scientist named Esteban.
Okay. And another scientist named Steven.
Thanks.
I can't think of another language that the name Steven exists in.
Stefano.
Oh, Stefan.
Stefano in Italian.
Stefano. Okay, they're all named variations of Steven.
Whatever Steven is in German.
We have German Steve, Steve, Steven, Stefano, and...
And Stefan.
Stefan.
Esteban.
And Stephanie, because scientists Stefan. Can be girls, too.
And Stephanie's one. Yeah. She was the one with the Bunsen burner.
Yeah.
I just didn't bring that up till right now because it wasn't relevant to Harry's story.
Yeah.